Hi everyone, welcome to this tutorial on how to get started with the .NET MAUI Expander control. The Expander control is a layout control capable of loading any UI view in both the header and content sections. In this video, I will demonstrate how to add Syncfusion .NET MAUI Expander control to a .NET MAUI project. Additionally, I will show you how to customize the duration of expanding and collapsing animations, as well as how to customize the appearance of the header. Before you begin, make sure you have installed the latest version of Visual Studio 2022 with the required .NET MAUI workload. You should also have one of the .NET SDKs installed on your machine. Once you have installed the necessary tools, launch Visual Studio 2022 and click Create a New Project from the dashboard. From the list of project templates, I select the .NET MAUI application. Then, provide the project name and location. After that, I'll proceed to create a project with the .NET 7.0 framework. Now, the default application is ready to use. Before I move forward, let me take a quick detour to set up the environment for running the application. Here, I select the Android emulator from this list to see the output in the Pixel 5 emulator. Once the emulator is selected, I will run the application and show you the default output. The application compiles a default code, so wait for a few seconds. And now, the application's homepage is displayed. Next, let me show you how to incorporate the expander control into this application. For that, I need to install the Syncfusion MAUI Expander NuGet package. So, I first open the NuGet package manager and switch to the Browse tab. From there, I search for the Syncfusion MAUI Expander package and select it to install in my project. Once the package is installed, I need to register the handler for the Syncfusion core to map the cross-platform control API to the native view API. To do this, open the MAUI program CS file and add the Syncfusion MAUI core hosting namespace. Then, register the Syncfusion core handler by adding the configure Syncfusion core method. To use the Syncfusion MAUI controls, it is necessary to register a trial license key. So, I open the app XAML CS file and add the register license method with the trial license key. To find out where to generate the trial license key, you'll find a link to instructions in the description below. Next, I will navigate to the main page XAML to initialize the control. I will remove the default code from the content page section and import the Syncfusion MAUI Expander namespace. Then, I will initialize the .NET MAUI Expander control to load any desired view. For example, I want to display the invoice date on the expander. To set the header for the expander, I define the header property. Inside the header, I add a grid control with a single row and two columns. First, I add a label to display the icon. Then, I set an appropriate value for the text property to show the icon and set its font family to accordion font icons. Accordion font icons is a custom font family that has been defined and added to the application's resources. Additionally, I customize the label by adding properties such as font size, margin, vertical options, and vertical text alignment. After that, I add another label in the second column to display the text in the header. I set its text to invoice date and customize it using properties such as font size, font family, character spacing, and vertical options. Similarly, to set the content for the expander, I will define the content property. Inside the content, I will add a grid control and set an appropriate value to the padding property. Then, I will add the label element within the grid and customize the label by setting properties for text, font size, font family, character spacing, and vertical options. Now, I run the application. As you can see, the .NET MAUI expander control is displayed on the emulator. By default, the expander is in a collapsed state and it's displaying the header only. To expand or collapse it, tap on the header. If you want to add multiple expanders to display various invoice details such as the invoice date, items, and payment details, load the existing expander for the invoice date inside scroll view and stack layout. Then, I add one expander for the purchased items. And add another expander for the payment details. Now you can see the extra two expanders are displayed for purchased items and payment detail. Next, to customize the animation duration for expanding and collapsing the expander control, you can set an appropriate value to the animation duration property, such as 500 milliseconds. By default, the animation duration is 300 milliseconds. You can see that the speed of the expanding and collapsing animation is customized. To programmatically expand or collapse an expander control, you can use the isExpanded property. For example, to programmatically expand the first expander, you can set the isExpanded property to true. Looking here, the first expander is expanded initially, and the other expanders are collapsed. If you want to control the expand and collapse interaction of an expander control, you can utilize the expanding and collapsing events provided by the control. The expander control offers four built-in events: expanding, expanded, collapsing, and collapsed. To disable expanding for the first expander control, you can define the expanding event and navigate to the event handler method. In this event handler, you can set the cancel property of the event arguments to true. This will prevent the first expander from expanding. Before running the application, remove the isExpanded property. Here, the first expander will be disabled and cannot be expanded, and the other expanders can still be expanded as usual. Similarly, to disable collapsing, remove the existing expanding event and define the collapsing event. Go to the collapsing event handler method. In this method, set the cancel property of the event arguments to true. This will prevent the first expander from collapsing. Here, the first expander will be disabled for collapsing, and the other expanders can still be collapsed as usual. Now, let's see how to customize the appearance of the expander header. Before starting, remove the code changes related to the collapsing event. To customize the position of the header icon in the expander, you can use the header icon position property and set an appropriate value, such as start. By default, the header icon position is end. Notice here that the header icon of the first expander is positioned on the start side, while the header icons of the other expanders will remain at the default position. To customize the appearance of the header in the expander, you can set an appropriate color to the header background and header icon color properties. In this example, set the header background property to light gray and the header icon color property to red for the first expander. You can see that the header background color and icon color of the first expander are customized according to the specified values, while the other expanders will retain their default colors. In this video, I have shown you how to create a .NET MAUI application and add the Syncfusion expander control to it. I also showed you how to customize the duration of expanding and collapsing animations and how to customize the appearance of the header. To learn more about expander features, you can check the documentation link provided in the description below. I have also included a link in the description where you can check if you qualify for our community license, which gives you a free license key for our entire .NET MAUI control suite. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.